think the starting place needs to be humility on our parts and a willingness to learn. Although we rightly view the scriptures as providing a comprehensive approach to people and their problems, that doesn't mean that we see everything. Okay, we live in God's world, all of us, secular psychologists as well as biblical counselors live in God's world. We are all image bearers. So even though the image has been marred because of the fall, there's a way in which we see, but we don't see clearly. We see some aspects of life more clearly than others. Scripture talks about God's common grace, the fact that he cares for all people. So that provides, I think, a backdrop and a rationale for saying we should understand what is out there in terms of secular diagnostic systems, different counseling methodologies. Even as we become more and more fully grounded in how the scriptures speak richly to people's lives in a gospel-centered, in a Christ-centered way. But these secular psychologists, or even folks from a different perspective, Christian perspective, may be giving us windows into places we haven't evaluated very well, but we haven't seen very clearly, both in terms of understanding the person's problem as well as what's helpful in terms of methodology. We always want to submit those, if you will, or run those through the grid of biblical revelation. However, I don't think we need to, as the saying goes, throw the baby out with the bathwater. The issue is how can we view, understand, and this is a term I think I've heard Winston Smith use, the gospel approximations that we see in these secular approaches, or again, other approaches that may not be right in line with a biblical counseling approach. What do we see that we can use? And I think that's back to the beginning. It's a posture of humility that I, as a counselor, as a biblical counselor, should be continuing to learn and grow. And be sent back to the scriptures and ask the hard questions of, well, how do I really help someone? What does scripture really say about this? My colleagues over here use this methodology and it really seems to be helpful, but it lacks the gospel. So how do I understand that in light of the way God has revealed himself? For example, cognitive behavioral therapy for OCD. That's kind of the gold standard in the secular world for approaching that problem. Now, how do I look at CBT? Well, I look through a gospel lens. I have a biblical perspective, a biblical worldview as I look at that. And what do I see? Well, I see it's right and appropriate to address our thoughts because our thoughts are revealing of ourselves, and ultimately are revealing of ourselves before God. So while it's important to address thoughts from a biblical point of view, I see that much deeper. It's a covenantal thing. My thoughts are not just things that I need to change, or I need to get rid of certain automatic thoughts and replace them with a different thought or a different kind of cognitive perspective. Rather, I bring my thoughts into submission to God. I ask questions like, well, what does this particular thought reveal about my view of God, my view of self, my view of others? And so while I may use some of those techniques, if you will, in terms of identifying particular thoughts and then suggesting certain actions in the moment, I'm also going to pursue that deeper and frame those thoughts and frame ultimately those actions that I call people to from a God-centered perspective.